Come with me to the exciting realm within the cells in your own body. This is where DNA is stored. You can think of DNA as a long list of recipes that tells your body how to make you who you are. DNA kind of looks like this, and the sequence of letters tells the body how to make proteins. The body reads the letters in the same way that we read steps and recipes. We're here to talk about changing instructions from the genetic code with CRISPR, but first, let's review the recipe for life. DNA is transcribed to RNA to be transported to the kitchen where the chef starts reading the recipe to assemble the protein. It grabs the ingredients and follows the instructions from the genetic code. But sometimes there are mistakes in the DNA. And in the same way that adding salt instead of sugar results in a wonky coffee, tiny mutations can cause big genetic diseases like sickle cell anemia and cystic fibrosis. The transcriber and the cook are doing their jobs properly, but the fault lies in the very set of instructions, in the code for life. Look, this is the recipe for hemoglobin, but ouch, it has a point mutation, and this is what causes sickle cell anemia. Up until recently, trying to fix this mistake was impractical, but with the help of CRISPR Cas9, modifying the instructions for life has become surprisingly cheap, accurate, and fast. Here's how it works.
CRISPR Cas9 is a tool used to edit genes, and it has two components. It has a pair of scissors that are used to cut the DNA strand, and an RNA sequence of 20 letters that tells it where to cut.
CRISPR Cas9 is first inserted to the nucleus of the cell, where it bounces around reading and comparing DNA until it finds a perfect match. When it finds it, it knows it's time to cut the sequence, creating a double-stranded cut at once. Talk about efficiency. When the cut is made, the cell activates its repair mechanism, and at this point, the cell can now do one of two things.
Scenario one, joining the two broken pieces of DNA while producing tiny mutations to deactivate the recipe. This is called non-homologous end joining, but this is not an option for hemoglobin. Or they can use homology-directed repair, and this is where things get interesting. In this case, the cell tries to repair the cut by copying the sequence from a backup copy of the same gene. As long as the beginning and the end are identical, the cell will assume that it's a natural sister DNA strand.
In our example, after CRISPR-Cas9 has cut off the point mutation in the hemoglobin gene, scientists introduce a new healthy sequence, and since the ends match, the repair mechanism takes care of the rest. And now, we have cured sickle cell anemia from this cell. It is really this efficient. This technology is amazing. It allows us to treat the causes instead of the consequences. Giving us the potential to cure genetic diseases, CRISPR-Cas9 has opened a new door in biomedical technologies. Advances like this have made the present crisp, but the future might be CRISPR.